Good evening, law student and legal professional who have joined with us in this webinar lecture series by Shri Ashok Arora sir on the topic of art of cross-examination. He is the former secretary of the Supreme Court Bar Association and the author of number of article and book. He has graduated from Hindu College and later studies law campus, Law Center, Delhi University. He had a career of 38 years in the area of litigation, practice, teaching, motivation, personality development, stress management, and communication skills. He established a school of training of mind and soul because of his firm belief that all the problems in the world today and because of lack of training, training of mind and soul. Now it's over to you, sir.
Okay, thank you, Sudhanshu. Good afternoon, everybody. I hope all of you are doing fine. I simply request all of you to kindly introduce yourself, say in one line. We can use at least 5 minutes or 6 minutes for introduction. My introduction, Sudhanshu very smartly has given. I will feel more comfortable if you guys just say in few words, like you say Sudhanshu, LLB first year, or Mritunjay, LLB second year from Rampur. I mean, let me just have introduction of at least few of you. If you can write on screen your name and place, the college, whatever you are doing. Like Sudhanshu, first year law, Rampur. Aditi, good Aditi. Thank you, you set the ball rolling, Aditi. Second time he's okay. I like this Aditi. Yes, anybody else? Vicky Gupta. Great, Dwarka. Oh, I am in Dwarka, Vicky. I am sitting in Dwarka at a friend's place to talk to you guys. Good, good. And I have been coming to Dwarka, your institute, many times. Astha, you are from where? Astha Maheshwari. Please write second year from this college. Let the introduction be smart so that I don't have to ask second question. Say Astha, second year. Nargis, second year, Mumbai. Good, Nargis. Nice to meet all of you. Hussain, practicing criminal law, Dhanbad, Jharkhand. Oh, I am also from Bihar, erstwhile Bihar. Okay. Who else is there? Sakhi Narvekar, Mumbai. Narvekar has to be from Mumbai. Good. Thank you, Sakhi. Somnath Gowda, Karnataka. Oh, Gowda in Karnataka, yes. Good, Somnath. Indajit Singh, advocate from Delhi. Great, Indajit. Who else is there? Astha Maheshwari, Bhim Rao Ambedkar. Oh, great. I think I visited Bhim Rao Ambedkar, Astha. Sujan from Sri Lanka. Great, Sujan. Great. Advocate Uma Pillai, civil lawyer, Mumbai. Great, Uma. Nice meeting you. Anybody else? Varsha Kumare, Law College, Thane. Yes, Varsha, nice meeting, second year. Who else is there? Pratibha. Pratibha from Karnataka, great Pratibha. Good, good. Kalyani Jadav, Mumbai. I am in 9th standard. Wow, that's great. Advocate Param Jadav, Delhi. Great Jadav sir, nice meeting you. Anubha Shirvastava, Anubha from Bangalore. Great Anubha, nice meeting you. Radhika from Kerala. Great. Anubha is practicing in Bangalore. Great. Good, I find quite a few practicing advocates. That's very nice. It would make me comfortable, in fact, and talking to friends is always. Indramani Upadhyay, Law College, second year. A great. Dr. Rupin, advocate from Uttar Pradesh. Wow. Arun Singh, law student, Lucknow. Great, Arun. G.S. Prakash from Bangalore. In between the talk also, if you wish to say something, like you wish to sometime appreciate, you may say wah, you may say nice, you may say bore, whatever you like, you may keep commenting. I would like that, so that I feel that yes, you guys are there and I'm talking to human beings, not to walls. Abhishek, Kalsi, Saharanpur, namaste sir, namaste. Good, nice, I like this. Namaste sir. Good. Mukul Girdhar, advocate, Delhi High Court. Oh wow, Mukul, nice meeting you. I'm also product of Delhi High Court, you must be aware. Chaliye, karte hain, I mean, anybody else? Next few minutes we start. Vishal Kumar, Bijapur. Great Vishal, nice meeting you. Archana from Rajasthan, nice Archana. Great. Anu. Anu Sharma, aapke charno mein vandan. I like this. I like this. Yeah, we have taken about 6 minutes in this. It is good, you know, in the process we settle down. In a way, it is also, you can say, first tip, I don't say lesson. First tip, you know, when you start cross-examining, you also settle down. Like the witness settles down. So when Sudhanshu talked of this topic, I told Sudhanshu and friends, you know, it is most important to know is that cross-examination is always a double-edged weapon. Many people, they spoil their own cases by asking irrelevant or sometimes the questions which ought not to be asked. So one is to be very, very, very careful before entering the cross-examination. Few things are very important to know, in which is basic to both civil and criminal law. That you must know what is your case, that is facts of the case. Most important is to know facts of the case. What is my case? And what do I want to prove? What do I want from this witness? That should be clear at the back of your mind. It should be absolutely clear that from this witness, I want this material. And what material do you want? As per your case and as per the case law. So what do you want to prove from that witness? So you must know what is the case law and also what are the facts. It is also important to know what the witness has already stated, say in his affidavit or in his statement before police. Because sometimes you have to confront that witness with the earlier statement. If you are a prosecutor or if you are a complainant or if you are a plaintiff, then definitely you have to train your witness. I never said tutor your witness. No. You have to train your witness. Sometimes witness is right, but witness doesn't know how to phrase cross-examination. So it is also your duty to train your witness that these are the questions which can be asked. I'm not saying tutor him or to tell him to make wrong statement. Because ultimately the idea is to do justice. And justice cannot be done if witnesses are telling lies. That is why justice delivery system in India is suffering a lot. Because many times, I remember when the great lawyer and great human being Ram Jethmalani was the president of Supreme Court Bar, only a few years back before he left us, He said it is such a difficult job for the judge to decide a case because both sides have filed wrong affidavits. So how do you prove then who is right? One side has filed an affidavit that he owes me $2 million. And the other side says, no, we have paid. Or for these reasons, this much was to be paid, this much was not to be paid. So if two sides are filing total contradictory affidavits or making contradictory statements, it is very difficult for the judge to decide the case. That is why we need good lawyers who can cross-examine the witness and can bring truth on record. If you ask me, I go to different school colleges and I ask students, what do you want to be? Sometimes they ask me, sir, okay, I want to be this. If you ask me, to be a lawyer is best profession. Although whatever you do in life, I say you must do. And in law profession, they say, what is best in law profession? I'll say litigation. In litigation, you ask me next question, what best in litigation? I'll say cross-examination. Because this is most challenging, most interesting, most difficult. Most difficult. As I said, at the cost of repetition, I say people spoil their own cases by asking irrelevant or sometimes even stupid questions, I say. So I love this. And if this is the mission to bring truth on record, that is challenging. Anybody can argue. I mean, nowadays students are very smart. You know, I many times judge moot courts and I see even first year, second year law students arguing so well. It's not very difficult to argue a matter. You have to say, Lord, PW1 said this, 2 said this, 3 said this. AIR 1975 this, AIR 85 this, 2000 this. So you are basically reading whatever is there. You are not creating like a painter, like a poet, like a musician, like Kabir, Ghalib, Bulle Shah, Socrates, Einstein. So when you are creating, it is very, very, very enjoyable. Very enjoyable, but very challenging. And it would not come in a platter. It would not come in a platter. You have to burn midnight oil to know what the facts are. Where do you want to bring the witness? If you are cross-examining an illiterate witness, style is different. If you are cross-examining some police officer's, style is different. If you are cross-examining some handwriting expert's, style is different. If you are cross-examining a judge who has recorded statement under 164, cross-examination is different. See, it is like Shakespeare says, "What is a stage? We are all actors. We are all actors." And cross-examination is a perfect stage to act. You really need to act very smartly if you really want to create something. Because you are creating. From witness, you want him to answer what you want him to say. According to your facts and case law, you want a witness to say something and you trap him, bring him there to say that thing which you want. Ye ishq nahi aasa aag ka darya. But it is doable. It is doable. It is doable if you know the law, if you know the facts, and also most important, if you ask me, most important is your own personality. After all, it is not a joke to make him say something which you want. At times you sort of hypnotize the witness. they eat from your hands. I'll tell you a few cases where they actually eat from your hands. They trap them so good. So that is the basic case law and facts. It is also important to know what the other side or the witness has already admitted. If the other side has admitted few things, there is no point harping upon those points. Sometimes people spoil their own cases by asking questions on facts which are already admitted, especially in civil cases. You need not focus on those where there is a clash of interest. You say something else, they say something else, and you want to prove that you are right. So you have to get it from that witness. So things admitted need not be asked. Your own personality, I say, is very important, because at times you have to think on your feet. Rather, most of the time you have to think on your feet. With one answer, the witness may demolish your next 100 questions or 10 questions, 50 questions. And where are you? You are at loss. I've seen lawyers, totally at loss, because they prepared a line of cross-examination and the witness answers something with which next 30 questions collapse. Rather, the whole cross-examination collapses. Then what do? Then you're looking at the roof here and there. So second line, plan B, plan C, plan D also should be clear in your mind. Clear in your mind. And your own sharpness is very important. A point which I coined and I love to share with you, my view is, purer the soul, whiter the mind, sharper the intellect. So your own personality, how pure, how good, how loving, how disciplined. You'll see, what is he talking? How disciplined are you? How pure are you? Is relevant. Because only purer soul would be quieter soul and would be sharper mind. Not everybody can think on his feet. Because if the overall personality is lying low, subdued, lethargic, not motivated, unfit for cross-examination. Unfit. Therefore, I say, develop your own personality. It's most important aspect of every aspect, of whatever profession you go. Even if you want to live life happily, I mean, you have to invest in your personality. And for cross-examination, it is most difficult, because you are getting something. I mean, you want something to eat, somebody to eat from your hands. I'll give you a couple of examples. The straightaway one example which comes to my mind, you might Google search it. There was a case where one Lakhubhai Pathak, if you search Acharwala from London, you can search it. He had filed a case against my client that he cheated him to the tune of 100,000 sterling pounds in London. And complaint was filed by CBI in Delhi against two of my clients. And the third person, who I knew was involved, but he was a big man. He was former prime minister of the country. Not only he was former prime minister of India, he was also de facto president, prime minister, because the then prime minister was dependent upon his support. His 100 odd MPs were giving that government support from outside. So even the central government, the prime minister was dependent upon that man who was a former prime minister. So therefore, CBI never wanted to make him accused. But I knew that he was an accused. So when I was cross-examining him, that Lakhubhai Pathak, acharwala from London, after a few questions, maybe after about an hour or maybe next day, I don't remember. But yes, not in the beginning. When he is connected with me, now he has started eating from my hands. He has developed some rapport with me. He is liking few things in me. I told him that you are such an experienced man. Your achar is being sold all over the world. You deal with businessmen from all over the world. It is not easy to befool you or to cheat you, because you are so experienced. You would not give money to any Tom, Dick or Harry, but to talk of a 100,000 sterling pounds, not even few hundred rupees. Nobody can befool you. You would give money, gentlemen, only if somebody big, somebody powerful, somebody reputed, somebody established, somebody in power asks you to give money. Otherwise, you will not give. You are not a fool. You are very experienced. He says, yes, yes, Mr. Arora, I am very experienced. Why should I give money? So I gave this money, 100,000 sterling pounds, because so and so asked me to pay. This is what I wanted. This is what I wanted, that since he asked you to pay, that is why you paid to these people. They were not in power. They were not men in position. Why should you pay to these people money unless somebody big says? He says, yes. I paid money because this gentleman asked me to pay. At that time, he was External Affairs Minister of India. After that, he became Prime Minister of India. And I have been pursuing this matter with him. Many times I wrote him. He promised me that yes, he'll resolve it. You see, he never said that you didn't pay on my saying. He never denied that. Imagine, at cross-examination, I still remember I had made a statement in the court that if I open my mouth, the government may fall. And actually, when the witness said that I paid money because that former Prime Minister asked me to pay, when this was recorded, firstly, there was dispute, lot of dispute, because CBI prosecutor and everybody was saying this will not be recorded. They said it is not our case, what Mr. Arora is asking. I said, gentlemen, prosecutor, this is not a stage to argue what is your case, what is my case. This is cross-examination of witness. He's my witness now. He's in my hands. Whatever he says should be truthfully recorded or not, that is the question. And the judge had no answer to say, yes, it should be truthfully recorded. So the moment it was recorded that I paid money because the former Prime Minister asked me to pay money, I said, hold on now. The judge said, what is now, Mr. Arora? It is recorded. It is over. Let's proceed. I said, no, my lord. Now things have changed. Now he has become an accused, which the CBI never wanted to do because he's so powerful. CBI never named him. Since the witness has said that I paid money because he asked me to pay, therefore he becomes main accused now. And he should be summoned under article section 319 of CRPC. And he was summoned as an accused for cheating, which summons were never set aside by the High Court nor by the Supreme Court. So this cross-examination led to his summoning, and his summoning led to fall of the then Prime Minister. Central government fell. In fact, after another government also fell. Two governments fell because of this incident, because of this cross-examination. Such is the power of cross-examination. And most important, why I say your own personality, because many times I see many lawyer friends are and why another are joining in this, they would tell you. And many times court would not give you that lift, would not acknowledge your presence, would try to sort of short circuit saying, okay, chalo, ho gaya. So your own personality should be such that the judge should not take you lightly. Now it is not in books, but it is practical experience of life which I am sharing. That is why I recite this couplet that dhoop mein niklo, ghatao mein nahakar dekho, zindagi kya hai kitabon ko hatakar dekho. Dhoop mein niklo, ghatao mein nahakar dekho, zindagi kya hai kitabon ko hatakar dekho. Sirf aankhon se hi duniya nahi dekhi jati, dil ki dhadkan ko bhi roshni banake dekho. So to read that person, you just don't need these eyes. You need this eye also. Intellect and soul. Dil ki dhadkan. Your experience should say, tell you he is telling lies. And you can tell the witness, look gentlemen, you are telling lies. And you must know the punishment is 7 years. So don't tell lies. So your confidence also would get you answers. But if your confidence is not there, judge is also scolding you, witness is also scolding you. Sometimes I have seen smart officers or people in power, they scold with lawyers, they misbehave with lawyers. So your personality should be such, like Iqbal says, khudi ko kar buland itna ki har takdeer se pehle, khuda bande se khud puche bata teri raza kya. Then only you can get cross-examined. Otherwise, witness also would snub you, court would snub you, other side would snub you. You should be strong enough. Otherwise, as I say, it becomes more difficult. Most difficult. Court should not take you lightly. I'm not saying disrespect the court or be offensive. No, be very respectful. Say it in a decent way. Tell the court, my lord, this is a very important question. My lord, may kindly bear me for a minute. Or send the witness out, I'll tell the relevance. Never tell the relevance in presence of witness. Say, my lord, may send the witness out, because when I say what is the relevance, the witness would get the answer. So you are justified in saying, my lord, may send the witness out, I'll tell the relevance. So that serves two purposes. First, the witness, when the judge says witness, go out for a minute. So he feels insulted. Your idea is not to insult. Again, you are doing justice. But strategically, you should not say in his presence, because that is stupid. Because sometimes when you say the relevance, the witness would get the hint of the answer. And it is perfectly justified in saying, Lord, we send him out. And sending out witness gets little frustrated and his ego is hurt. Why are they sending me out? Then if there are two witnesses, like two punch witnesses, you can always say, I will examine both the witnesses together. I mean, on the same day. Otherwise, whatever I examine one day, that witness would tell to the other punch witness, the very purpose of second witness and bringing contradiction would be defeated. So always, when there are two witnesses, you say of the same incident, you say that, no, I will examine them together. I'm not bothering you with those questions and sections, whichever is available on Google, I normally don't discuss. That's 130 onwards, those sections you have to see. But you must know. Which is leading question, which is scandalous question you can't ask. But you can always ask a question to shake the credibility of the witness. When you can examine your own witness, these are also 130 onward, you see all these sections would make it clear. I mean, there's nothing difficult about this. Your confidence to shake the credibility of witness, you can always ask as many questions as you want. And at times it is required. If you are cross-examining, you should be confident. If your witness is being cross-examined, you trained him, make him comfortable, tell him these are the questions which can be asked. Not tutor, I again say not tutor. He should not make false statement. We are not to encourage people or tell people to make false statement, but tell them to make correct statement and stand test of judicial scrutiny. Like if witness, there is an accident, witness of accident. He need not remember how much was the speed. He need not say it was 73.2 point speed. No, no need to say that. Simply witness said that this he was driving at much higher speed than the normal traffic. That's all. Your purpose is served. He was driving at much higher speed than the normal traffic. I saw that. Purpose is served. Then, as I said, what you want to bring on record. The other important case which I dealt and I love to share with friends and students, I would say that was the most difficult witness ever. You can well imagine if Ram Jethmalani himself is witness, how difficult this would be to cross-examine Ram Jethmalani. I was engaged to cross-examine Ram Jethmalani in a case. It was open and shut case, in fact. But I prepared well. So I wanted to know the witness, know more about him before I started cross-examination. Apart from facts. Facts is one part. Then if I am to shake credibility, I am to ask different questions. So you have to ask some questions which would make the other person uncomfortable, which would make the court doubt the testimony. Then create doubt. After in criminal trial, you don't have to prove beyond reasonable doubt that you are innocent. Prosecution is to prove. So you have to simply create a doubt in the mind of the court. And I share with you, I mean, I started with a why I'm sharing, because sometime when you have a good witness, but witness is over smart, over confident, that witness may spoil your case. So from a witness who is over qualified, over smart, over confident, you have to prepare him very well and train him, in fact. So Ram Jethmalani never thought that somebody can cross examine him, especially because he had filed a case which was open and shut case. Imagine I ask him first question. Mr. Jethmalani. Oh, this is the question. Imagine from Jethmalani, such a great lawyer, somebody is asking, I mean, a young lawyer. I didn't have my this gray beard and mustache that time. I was very handsome and young. I'm still handsome, I know, but I was very handsome, very young. A young lawyer asking Jethmalani question, cross-examining him and asking him a stupid question, innocuous question, annoying question. Now, in retrospect, I say it was annoying and it served my purpose. But it was relevant, so I could ask. I asked him, Mr. Jethmalani, please tell the court, where do you stay? I hope you got the question. Somebody is asking Jethmalani, Mr. Jethmalani, please tell the court, where do you stay? It's a stupid question, no good question. And he says, what is this question? Actually, he was very, you know, aggressive and very powerful man. So he would not take any nonsense. So his reflex action was, what is this question? But that served my purpose. He was annoyed right from the beginning. I said, look, Mr. Jethmalani, you're not to make faces. If question is relevant, please answer the question. If you feel question is irrelevant, please tell the court there is an objection and tell what is the objection. Naturally, the cross-examination had just started. And the judge, already I had a session with him and he knew. Now, this is what I am saying is important. He knew that Mr. Arora cannot be brushed aside like this. He knows his case well. He knows a little bit law also. He can argue a little bit. He can counter a little bit. He would not take any injustice. So this personality of yours should be clear in the mind of the court as well as the other side and witnesses. Therefore, the judge quickly asked him, Mr. Jethmalani, what is the problem? It's a simple question, you answer. What is wrong with it? Just answer, it has just started. Let's see how it moves. He said, okay, take down. I stay in Bombay for my personal life. Now, this is the answer of Mr. Jethmalani. I stay in Bombay for my personal life and for my professional life, I live in Delhi. Okay. At that time, there were no computers. This was typewriter. So, it is being typed. I stay in Bombay for my personal life and for my professional life, I stay in Delhi. Yes, Mr. Arora. Next question. Yes, Mr. Jethmalani. Now, please tell the court, where are you member of Rajya Sabha from? Second question, where are you member of Rajya Sabha from? And he's again annoyed and irritated and says, what is this? Is it election petition? I said, no, Mr. Jethmalani, it is not election petition. But this would decide your credibility now right in the second question. Because at that time, you ought to be resident of that state from where you contest election. Now it is not necessary. You can contest from anywhere in the country. That time it was necessary that if you are contesting Rajya Sabha, you should be resident of that state. And if you are, so I have to have in my mind, where is the member of Rajya Sabha from? How did he contest? If he contested, then definitely he filled the form and residence as Karnataka, not Delhi. I had this information. He says, yes, I am a member of Rajya Sabha from Karnataka. Okay. What have you filled the form in the column residence? What have you filled your residence in that form? Karnataka or Delhi? He says, naturally Karnataka. Bangalore. See, second question, credibility is shaken. Witness is shaken, such a great man, because he knows that, yes, he has been caught on wrong foot. I said, now please tell the court how many months you stayed in Karnataka, if that is your residence as per nomination form. How many months you stayed there? He said, no, I never stayed a few months. Did you stay a few weeks? No, I never stayed a few weeks. Because I knew, this fact I know, that such a busy lawyer, he just cannot afford to stay a few weeks in Bangalore. And he has said he is in Bombay and Delhi mainly. I also knew that he was once member of Rajya Sabha with the support of Shiv Sena. So I asked him that once you were elected member of Rajya Sabha with the support of Shiv Sena. I said, yes. So if you are getting, now my question is, if you are getting support from a particular political party and they are giving you Rajya Sabha ticket, it is very natural that you agree with them at least on few points, if not on all the points. Now see how you plan question. I know the truth. Like I said, zindagi kya hai, kitabon ko hata kar dekho. And I know his personality, that he is not the man who would be in control of anybody, any political party. He would differ also at few points. So keeping that in mind, I asked that it is sure that you agree with few of the policies. He says, yes, it is sure that yes, I agree with few of the policies. That is why they supported me. And it is also sure that you don't agree with all their policies. I know he cannot take anything for, nobody can dictate him. He said, yes, it is true. I do not agree with all their policies. Now, naturally, next question is, please tell the court, which are those policies which you don't support? Some important policy. So witness is saying, I am getting the support of this party to become Rajya Sabha member, but I don't support their policies, all the policies. There's nothing wrong in that. But I am only trying to shake the credibility. I am legally authorized to do that. And not only that, by making me uncomfortable, I may get another good answer. Because now he wants to wind up, he says, finish karo. So that's why I said, my dear friends, it's very, very important to know the witness, to have your own personality, plan it well. Suggestion. I mean, I recently was in a court, I tell you. Sometimes, I mean, it is very important to give all the suggestions. Whatever is your case, you have to put it to witness. It is very important. Let him deny it. You have to tell him, look, gentleman, you gave him beatings to get this statement. You forced this statement on me, on him. You have to put it on record. Whatever is your case, let him say no. But you have to put it. Like, I mean, I'll give you another example. Like in custom cases, where the statement, you all know, statement made before police officer is not admissible, but statement made before custom officer is admissible in law. So therefore, what do? We try to create circumstances or project circumstances, demonstrate circumstances which reflect that this statement was forced upon me. He was beaten or was tortured to make this statement. So I bring in circumstances. I ask, when was the passenger apprehended? When did the flight land? When did you call witnesses? When was the recovery proceedings complete? When did you record this statement? When did you produce this man in court? So you're getting the timing, you know, trying to bring a point that say if seizure formalities, you know, if seizure gold is recovered, seizure formalities are over by 12 noon or say by midnight, or normally flights are midnight. So seizure formalities are over by midnight, but person is produced at 2 p.m. Statement is recorded by 1 p.m. So from 1 a.m. till 1 p.m., 12 hours you took to record these two pages. This is sufficient. Sufficient to create doubt in the mind of the court that this was torture. Then you make it arguable. You can say, you know, the witness would not come and say, I gave him beatings. I'm only to create grounds. I am to show you the circumstances. If it took them 12 hours, six men recording the statement, that is torture. What else is torture? He would not come and say, yes, I gave beatings. He's a seasoned officer, gazetted officer. So I know the law that court says, Supreme Court says, you have to only create doubt in the mind of the court that the statement is not voluntary. So I am to ask questions on these lines. But suggestion I have to give, look, I am putting it to you. Let him deny that you, all of you, five, six of you gave him beatings or tortured him to make statement. Let him say it is incorrect to suggest that we gave him beatings to record his involuntary statement. But even suggestions, I say, friends, one is to be very, very, very particular. Why I'm saying this with my experience, many times when we dictate suggestions, court is also casual, the other side is also casual, we are also casual. We just say, okay, right, incorrect to say deposing falsely, incorrect to say I am making a statement with a motive to punish him or for these reasons. I remember a case in recently, like when you are examining handwriting expert or any expert or a doctor, it is very important to understand that medical certificate, sitting with a doctor and understand what are the points involved and accordingly you question to build your own case. Very, very important. If you are examining some expert, you must talk to some other expert about that document. And accordingly, you question. as per the case law applicable in your case or your defense. I remember a friend of mine, I mean, he was dictating a suggestion, so I do not wish to name. I was sitting there because I was also counsel for one of the accused. And he dictated that it is incorrect to suggest that handwriting at some places is same, some places different. There are variations in admitted and sample handwriting. When you say it is correct, there are variations. He had said there are variations. But there are similarities also. So this should be recorded separately. Your suggestion is only this, that you did say that there are variations. Because you want to only show there are variations, it is not my handwriting. So you can't say in one sentence, it is correct to say there are variations, but there are similarities also. That means you are also admitting the similarities. I was just sitting quiet, and once I saw this being recorded, I just got up from my chair and I said, my lord, please. May I give a suggestion? He said, it is his witness, prosecution, and it is. I said, my lord, I'm sorry, I'm sitting in court. I'm an officer of court. I'm counsel for one of the co-accused. And most important is what he wants to say should be recorded. Even if he's committing mistake, it should be recorded in two parts. That it is correct to say that there are variations in the sample handwriting and admitted handwriting. Full stop. Now, voluntarily, witness says that there are similarities also. So, this should come as his statement voluntarily. I have not asked about similarities. I have only asked about variations. If you record in one line, it would mean that I am admitting similarities, I am also admitting variations. No, I am only asking the witness, there are some variations. See, innocuous suggestion also sometimes can spoil your own case. Not till Supreme Court you are blocked. Court would say you have admitted there are variations, there are similarities also. So where is the doubt? It happens. So. Very, very important. Very important that suggestion also should be neatly, nicely recorded. One by one, not in group. One by one you record the suggestions. Stop witness. This is very important, especially in criminal cases, you know, that there are stop witnesses. One police station would have one person as witness in 20 cases, 30 cases. So now if you get such case, it is your duty to find out in how many cases that witness has appeared as a punch witness or as a recovery witness. Maybe in that police station or some other adjoining police station, so that you can tell the court he's a stop witness. He's not reliable. I'll tell you a very interesting instance about stop witness, which I examined police officer. And I asked the investigative officer. Now again, you know, in retrospect also, I enjoy this thought that how it happened. I know I was to examine a witness and I was also to go to High Court. Witness was present, that police officer. And I knew that his punch witness was a stock witness. He had appeared in many cases of his. So I told the court, I said, my lord, I am to go to High Court and in fact, I have a couple of questions. If quickly he can answer, I can examine him now. Otherwise, let him come some other day. So I knew the natural tendency of the judge would be that why adjourn? Every judge would say, why at Jan? You examine, ask quickly 2-3 questions. Now you are here, witness is here. You ask these questions and then you go. So that was my plan, frankly, to make that witness casual. And I succeeded. You just 1-2 questions I am to ask, not answer. So question I am asking from that witness, investigating officer, that nowadays, you know, people don't help. People don't come forward to give witness. Again, zindagi kya hai, kitabon ko hata kar dekho. I know that people don't come forward to give witness. I know this fact. So how can the policeman would say, no, no, everybody is willing to give witness. Naturally, he would say, yes, people don't come forward. So I said, look, people don't come forward. Even for a serious cases, sometimes you don't find a witness. People are scared, people are apprehensive ki court jana padega bar bar, kaun chakkar lagayega, chodo witness kya dena. He says, yes, you're right, Mr. Arora. People don't come forward to give witness. But I said, this gentleman is very nice, you know. He's very helpful, socially conscious. He tries to help everybody, policeman, every social activity. He's very social. He says, yes, he's very social. He's always helpful. And he's always there to witness whenever you call him. He says, yes, normally, whenever you call him. As in how many cases he has been your witness? No, my goodness, he was a smart officer. He got the hint now, but he, by that time he was trapped. He says, I don't remember in how many cases. I said, you don't remember? Maybe he has appeared in your 200 cases? He says, no, no, not 200. I said, maybe 15, 20 cases? He says, maybe 10, 15 cases. Maybe 10, 15 cases, he said. He's my witness. What else you need to answer? I said, okay, record this note, I'm going. Thank you. If you get time, you can also search, you know, I mean, the few important, very historical cases where I had the occasion to cross-examine witness, like JMM case where the parliamentarians were bribed, Hawala case where cutting across party lines, all political parties, they had their senior members involved in those matters and they were tried, most of them were acquitted, discharged, that is different. So these are important cross-examinations which you can search. Then Rajiv Gandhi assassination, the trial where it was going on, the Gyan Bhavan, that inquiry commission, those were important witnesses. And I always tell at least lawyers, young lawyers and students, you know, whenever you get an opportunity, in every city there are few good lawyers who are good in cross-examination. In every city we have, that will be a very fortunate. So just ask them whenever there is a case, they are conducting cross-examination. If they give you liberty, go and read the file before the cross-examination. Read the whole case before the cross-examination. Not only that witness, whole case. Just go and sit with them or read the file, and when the witness is to be cross-examined, go there. Because that aura, that body language is very important, very important. As I said, sometimes witnesses is a bully. So you have to set him right. How to say is very important. As I said, it's every time your tone, texture, volume, language should be different. I mean, the guy who doesn't understand English, you ask him in a slang, oh, what are you talking? And what is that? No, no, no. You're not to create a scene in the court and create an atmosphere which is uncomfortable for you also. Because the judge would not like if you, I mean, the witness doesn't understand English and you are trying to act smart with him. You ask him in local language then. This adds to your personality. That is what I am saying. You may be firm. You may ask whatever you want to ask, even if the person is embarrassed. That is not your problem. You have to do your come. At times, I mean, you may embarrass a person. I distinctly remember, I don't feel shy and guilty because that was my brief to expose that witness. Very senior government officer, I asked him in open court. I said, gentlemen, look, you were arrested for corruption and you were in jail for a few days. He says, yes. He had to admit he had no answer. But when you ask this question in presence of, in open court, in presence of 1,500 people, the witness is shaken. He can't say no. That is a fact. But again, not unnecessarily. There should be purpose behind. As I said, this is a special section. You can't ask scandalous question. But it is not scandalous. I'm not trying to scandalize. I'm only trying to shake his credibility that he himself is corrupt. How do we believe him as a witness? So that thin dividing line, what is scandalous and what is justified to be asked, depends upon from case to case. But you should be sure about yourself that what you have to ask. Therefore, time and again, I say, your own personality, your own thinking on your feet would not come in a flutter. Would not. You have to work very, very, very hard with discipline on yourself. Make life a celebration. Life is a celebration. If you think that life is a celebration, if you are positive in your approach, your intellect would be much sharper than a dull man. If you are helpful to people, your confidence would be much higher. If you are of a loving nature, your confidence would be much higher. I can suggest, I am not saying believe me, my dear friends. I never said believe me. I said try it. Experiment it. With your own experience, you observe whether when you are loving, you are happy or not. When you are focused, you are happy or not. When you are disciplined, when you know what to speak, when to be in silence, how to speak, how to ask. Same question. It is not like a computer. You're not talking to a computer. You're talking to a man, human being. And a human being is observing you. He's your captain in that field. He can say, no, this is not the way, Mr. Arora. Don't try to intimidate the witness. Don't do this. And if a judge scolds you in presence of witness, your confidence is shaken and his confidence goes much higher. So that's why I say, Ishq nahi aasa, aag ka darya. You have to think all these lines. Your own discipline, your own food habits, your own attitude in life, your mission in life. Are you a person selfish or you are helpful to others? Are you an asset to society or a liability to society? I mean, very few persons. Why I'm sharing, I'm so thankful to Sudhanshu and team. You know, they invite you guys and invite some people to speak or experienced people to speak. It's very important to learn. And this COVID time, I say, you can use best. See some cross-examination, read some cross-examination. Build your own personality where you can think out of the box. Out of the box. And at times, I tell you, as I was telling you, the witness I embarrassed, he told my friend, he said, I felt like committing suicide in court. He embarrassed me so much. But my purpose was to make him humble because he was telling lies. He was caught. You have to be sure about yourself. Not to do injustice, to bring truth on record. Your purpose should be to bring truth on record and to expose the wrong doer or the liar. If somebody is telling lie, he must be exposed. In fact, this is very unfortunate. I request you guys to work on that, that there should be some system where all the law is there that making false statement in court is punishable with 7 years. But how many people you feel are punished? No one. That's a very sad commentary. It speaks very poor of our nation, I'd say. That in foreign countries, people don't tell lies on oath. Here, anybody can make any statement. So it is our duty as lawyers during cross-examination to bring on record that these people are telling lies and they should be prosecuted. I'm not saying you prosecute everybody under the sun, but in few prominent cases where the message goes to society, in fact, by cross-examination, you can do this great service to society. That bring on record some people who are making false statements and then ask the court to request the court to prosecute them. I'm very sure if few people are prosecuted, sent to jail, then people would stop telling lies in court. In Temple of Justice, I mean, people, they make one statement before the police officer, electronic media, they made another statement. In print media, they will make another statement. In social media, they are making another statement. And when ultimately they go to court, they are making another statement. With total impunity, you are telling lies. And you say, Satya Mev Jayate. Mahatma Gandhi ka truth is God. Where is truth? It's very difficult to reach truth. That's why cross-examination is very important. And some cases, it doesn't reach because people are poorly cross-examined. Poorly cross-examined. People, I mean, lawyers, sometimes they do not work hard on their brief. Ultimately, sometimes the man is wrongly convicted or wrongly acquitted. So this is what I wanted to talk. Oh my God, it's already 1 hour. If you guys have some question, quickly you can ask, or otherwise, Sudhanshu, I mean, my email you guys can note. My email is very simple, ashokarora2310@gmail.com. 2310 is my date of birth. Recently, I completed my 64th birthday. You can send gifts also, but if not sending gifts, at least to remember, email ashokarora2310@gmail.com. You can email me. A few of us, we do a lot of, with Sudhanshu and other friends, we do a lot of free legal aid work. If you feel we can be of any help to you in any legal matter or social matter or otherwise, or you have to consult us, say, even if you are charging fee, charge fee, whatever you want to charge, and you want to just have guidance from us, I say, now we have earned whatever we wanted to earn. You should make good money and also do social service side by side. Bring truth on record. That would really make you happy. I'm saying, if you would really feel top of the world, if you can bring truth on record and expose somebody who is telling lies. And if you want to discuss, then also email me and we can fix a time. And Sudhanshu has my number, many others. Otherwise, also you can get my number also. There's no problem, but I don't take call. Just WhatsApp me or email me that you want to talk, then of course I'll call you back. And you can send your questions by email if you are not ready with the questions. A couple of questions, Sudhanshu, we can take quickly if you want.
What procedure should we adopt if the judge refuses our request to cross-examination all the witnesses on the same day?
All the witnesses cannot be examined on same day. One should be practical also. So practical is that only you say that these two witnesses who are on the same day, same place. You can't examine all the witnesses on one day. That request is unfair, although it should happen. But we have so many cases, so it doesn't happen. Otherwise, it should be allowed.
What are the key points we have to follow while we cross-examine?
This is what all I discussed in 1 hour. You're wanting me to go through again. You should know what the witness would answer yourself, within yourself. What would be the answer? What do you want from him? These are important things. No issues with answer. I mean, please tell everybody to email the questions. Thank you very much. And I had good time.
Yes, sir.
You made my Sunday. Thank you so much. You know, be with friends and just email me. Even your case, you can discuss in time. You email me. And the only thing is to fix time with me, which is convenient time, I'll tell you. Normally, I mean, I would request everybody to don't call me before 4 p.m. Whether it is Saturday, Sunday, or both work. Always text me. If it is extreme urgent, you can always call. There's nothing wrong if it is extreme urgent. You email me or text me. But normally you call me after 4 and I fix time between 4 and 10 to discuss a couple of cases every day.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Bye,
everybody. Thank you so much.
Stay safe. Enjoy life. Complete life full. Life king size. Then only you can be a smart lawyer. Thank you. Bye, everybody. Bye.